morning from Moho Resources is Ralph Winter. Ralph, morning. Good to see you.
Morning, Andrew. Yeah, long time no see. How you been?
Certainly has, Ralph. I've been well, thank you. You guys have been busy. You've been doing some surface sampling here at Silver Swan North. Give us a bit of an update. How's it been?
Yeah, look, the results that came back were very positive. We ended up doing a more closed space surface sampling campaign across the majority of our Silver Swan North tenements there, and also into some newly acquired tenements that we've just optioned from a few prospectors in close proximity just around our tenements. The takeaway from it is we've started with our East Sampson Dam prospect, which is about 300 meters long. And we've now extended the surface gold anomalism approximately 3 kilometers to the northeast on that. And we have a semi-continuous gold anomalism length of about, it's about 11 kilometers, give or take, from the northwest end down to the southeast. So I've got a lot of room to work there, but I guess the prospect we've got to move into in terms of extending our potential production there that we're looking to get up and running. So
with the surface sampling here, Ralph, was the idea to define some future drill targets in the area?
Yes. I mean, we had a fair idea that there was a trend heading up that way, but obviously until you do the sampling, you don't know for sure. The idea was really just to vector in on where those zones were so that we could go in. So following this, we aim to do an air core program across those anomalies, probably early next year. We hope to get it out in about January next year. And we'll do a nice extensive air core program across that, and that'll really define where the mineralization might be sitting. And then we can further do some additional drilling on that and define it to look at extending our potential mining capabilities at East Sampson Dam. Yeah.
You're currently doing some diamond drilling out there too, Ralph. How's that going? What's the objective?
So the diamond drilling it's a few things. One, it's geotechnical, so we've got to look at how the pit walls might shape up once we actually start digging and that kind of stuff. There's a bit of metallurgical work in that as well, and structure control, see where all the faults and the structures lie. All of that's very important for our mine planning, make sure that we know where we're going. And also in amongst all of that, there'll also be some good gold results coming out, hopefully, because it will be drilling, the areas of the body that it should have some nice anomalism in it. So we hope to have our first batch of results in that come out probably in the next week or two. So that should be exciting, hopefully. And then there'll probably be one or two more batches after that heading towards the end of the year.
Is it 10 holes that you're putting in here as part of this program?
We were going to do 6 initially, and we've expanded the program to 10 now. So I anticipate we'll probably put out 3 or 4 in our first batch of results. Being diamond drilling, unfortunately, it takes, it's a bit slower than your RC or your air core drilling. You might do 20 meters a day sort of thing. So it takes a little bit longer to get the results out there. Yeah.
What about across in Queensland at Empress Springs? What's happening here?
We've been a little bit busy there. Unfortunately, with the whole COVID thing, we're a bit hampered in terms of getting rigs on the ground. But we did have a program with CSIRO to do some hydrogeochemical sampling, which we've just completed. That's essentially sampling all the water bores across that region, because we now hold 2,300 plus square kilometers of ground in that area. And as you can imagine, for a small company, we need to find, creative and inventive and cheaper ways to zone in on where the mineralization might be. So the idea is that once you sample the water bores, there should be trace elements of the mineralization in the water. And then that'll give you sort of a 5 kilometer radius in which you can then vector in and start to do further work and see where the mineralization might lie. So we finished that. We've also done, we're about halfway through an IP survey, which we'll now have to come back next year and finalize as well. But the results from the hydrogeochem we're expecting towards the end of this month. And there's some isotope sampling from that, which it was sent over to Canada to have the isotope sampling done. And we'll expect that also towards the end of the year. So a lot happening on all fronts on our end, and we're keeping our guys busy. I don't think they've seen the office in a long time. They've been out in the field working hard. So
it certainly is a lot going on, Ralph. Just a final reminder for people watching then, what can we expect near term as far as news from you?
So apart from the stuff we've already mentioned, so we got results from the diamond drilling. We're to start an RC drill campaign following the diamond drilling towards the end of this year as well. And then early next year, we'll have an air core campaign. So there'll be a series of results coming out from all these drill campaigns at Silver Swan North Project. All going well, we'll also do an RC and diamond program at our Burrakoppen project in the wheat belt, because that'll be open now once the harvesting's completed at the end of this year. And we can then do some drilling on that one as well, which the guys are quite excited about from our last results. A lot of drilling results coming out. Like I said, the hydrogeochem from Empress Springs, once we have a good idea of where that lies, we can then plan a program for next year after the wet season finishes, probably about March, April. And then, yeah, look, it's, you know, those are sort of the major things. We're also finalizing our mining studies. We're looking to get our JORC resource out for Silver Swan North probably early next year now, given the slippages with the drill rig availabilities, unfortunately. And the scoping study we're still aiming to get out before the middle of next year. So all going well, we're on track to begin our digging towards, well, in the second half of next year, basically. So, yeah.
Plenty to look out for. Ralph, great to catch up. Thanks for your time.
Great, Andrew. Thanks very much for your time. Have a good day.